be thou exalted, O Lord, above all heavens. Be thou exalted, O Lord, above all heavens. Let your glory be above all the earth. Let your glory be above all the earth. Hallelujah. Today is Thursday, 2nd April 2020. And I want to thank you for making time to watch this encouragement series video. All praise be to God, our ever faithful one. I bring you greetings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And on behalf of all of us from Church of the Resurrection, 1004 Victoria Island, Lagos, I say peace be unto you. It is my pleasure to speak to you in the name of our Lord and only Savior, Jesus Christ. Our words of prayer shall find fulfillment in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Psalm 57 verse 1 says, "Be merciful unto me, O God, be merciful unto me, for my soul trusteth in thee. Yea, in the shadow of thy wings will I make my refuge, until these calamities be overpassed." The psalm is a Davidic one, when he fled before Saul into the cave. David ran for his dear life when Saul, the king of Israel, was after him. Just as we are all running for our dear lives from the destruction of coronavirus, David called upon God, asking for mercy. "Be merciful unto me, O God. Be merciful unto me," says David. We all need the mercy of God on a daily basis, particularly at this time that COVID-19 is ravaging the world. It is only mercy that can make us to stand before God. God is the Father of all mercy. And I pray for you, the mercy of God shall rest on you in the name of Jesus Christ. This psalm is a song from the bowel of the earth, just as Jonah's prayer was from the bowel of the sea. David was like saying, "This cave alone cannot hide me from this danger and destruction. I take refuge in the shadow of thy wind." Verse 3 says, "He reached down from heaven and saved me, challenging the one who trampled me." God will reach down to save each and every one of us. God will uproot the power of coronavirus in the name of Jesus. In times like this, we need more than precautions. We need more than sanitizer. We need to take refuge in the Rock of Ages until this calamity be passed. And even after, we should continue to take refuge in God, because the tempest of this time is for a matter of time, but our safety is a matter of eternity. The psalmist had no doubt that what he needed was God's support while the trouble endured. In this time of stress, I pray that the Lord will support you, your family, our nation, and beyond in the name of Jesus Christ. It was a great act of faith for David to trust in God at such a time like this. And it is still an act of faith to look unto God in total trust at such a time like this. What God did for one, he is able to do for another. God kept David from all the plans and traps of Saul the king. David saw the end of King Saul, and I know
that you will see the end of COVID-19. Let us act like David. The power is in the place of prayer. No matter where you are right now, the God who answered David from the cave and Jonah from the belly of the fish can also answer your prayer, no matter your location. I am confident that God will keep you safe. I am confident that His hands will uphold you and uphold your children. I am sure that the winds of God's mercy will visit all the nations of the earth in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for joining this session. Feel free to share with your friends and family. God bless you. Amen.